So we've talked a lot on this channel recently about QYLD, the NASDAQ 100 Covered Call ETF. And we also looked at how this fund compared to actually the underlying index, QQQ. But is there a way for us to get our greedy little hands on a little bit of growth and a little bit of income? What's up, you guys? Welcome back to the Average Joe Investor Channel. My name is Joe, and in this video, we are doing a breakdown of not just QYLD and not just QQQ, but an investment option in the middle here. A little bit of growth, a little bit of income, QYLG and QQQX. In this video, I'm gonna break down for you the differences between these four investments, three of which are exchange traded funds, one of which is a closed end fund. And then we're going to, as customer on this channel, open up a spreadsheet and talk about the actual real differences that would have occurred if we'd invested in these funds with a lump sum investment strategy, a monthly investment with reinvested dividends and without, over three different time periods to make sure we can look at an apples to apples comparison. Oh man, I love talking about dividend stocks, dividend ETFs, cash flow, any type of investment strategy for the average Joe out there. So if you appreciate this video, if you learn something new or this video leads you to make a great investment decision, then hit that like button. Hit the subscribe button and let's get started. Hey guys, Joe here. If you're new to the channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button below the video to make sure you don't miss any of my future videos. And if you do click that subscribe button, make sure to leave me a comment below saying you subscribed, and I promise to personally respond to your comment. You guys know I never want to waste your time and I want to deliver massive value as quickly as possible with every video I make. So let's not waste any time. Let's jump right into the content. All right, first off here, guys, let's just go over briefly the four different players, the four different investments in this video here. First off, let's talk a little bit about QQQ. This is an ETF, a very popular ETF. It tracks the NASDAQ 100 index. This index, as it says here, includes the 100 largest non-financial companies listed on the NASDAQ based on their market capitalization. In other words, how valuable the company is. Now, when we're talking about QQQ, the NASDAQ 100 index, we're talking very much about a heavily weighted information technology index here. Top holdings: Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, Tesla, Facebook, Google, both Class A and Class C, Nvidia, PayPal, Intel, and there's quite a few, 100 actually. They're very tech oriented. You can see that right here. 48.11% of the companies in this investment are information technology, another almost 20% in communication services. With QYLD, we're still talking about the NASDAQ 100, but it's a different investing strategy altogether. Yes, the actual investment includes the NASDAQ 100 actual companies in it, where companies like Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, Google, Facebook, Tesla, all these companies are the same ones that are in QQQ, except in addition to owning these companies, the NASDAQ 100 covered calls, it says right here, in addition to owning those companies, they also write or sell corresponding call options on the same index. This is why QYLD has such high cash flow. They sell covered call options on top of these underlying investments, which generates a lot of option premium, which is the basis for all of this income coming to investors. I forgot to mention here with QQQ, it does have a total expense ratio of 0.20%. With respect to QYLD, we have an expense ratio of 0.60%, but as you can see here, the dividend yield is 12.44%, and it pays monthly distributions. The whole point of this video is to talk about two other investments that are very similar to each other, but one has a lot longer history and has been mentioned quite a bit in the comments of my video, so I wanted to address it. First off, we've got from the Global X here, we've got QYLG, the NASDAQ 100 Covered Call and Growth ETF. That's just a fancy way of saying that they're selling options on a smaller portion of the portfolio. Otherwise, same strategy. As it says right here, follows a covered call or buy right strategy in which the fund buys the stocks in the NASDAQ 100 index and writes or sells corresponding call options on approximately 50% of the value of the portfolio, whereas QYLD sold it on 100% of the portfolio. With this fund, we also have a 0.60% expense ratio and 103 holdings, just like QYLD. But the distribution yield on QYLG is about 50%. It's about 6% versus 12% with QYLD. Otherwise, it's the exact same investment strategy. Now, the fourth investment here is one that's very interesting, and that is QQQX. It's the Nuveen NASDAQ 100 Dynamic Override Fund, QQQX. This fund is designed to offer regular distributions through a strategy that seeks attractive total return with less volatility than the NASDAQ 100 index by investing in an equity portfolio that seeks to substantially replicate the price movements of the NASDAQ 100 index, as well as selling call options on 35% to 75% of the value of the fund's equity portfolio with a long-term target of 55%. Now, this is a closed-end fund. We haven't talked about closed-end funds on the channel, though I may have to make an introduction for the average Joe to closed-end funds. There are some intricate differences between closed-end funds and open-ended mutual funds and ETFs. I don't want to go into those differences right now, but let me know in the comments below if you would like to know more about how closed-end funds operate. It can be a great way to generate income, but there are some concerns with closed-end funds that you have to watch out for as well. With QQQX, it's got 124 different holdings. It's got an annual expense ratio of 0.94%, which is a little bit on the high side. It's definitely more than QQQ or QYLD, QYLG. And QQQX does not pay monthly. It pays a quarterly distribution right around 6.6%. And this fund has been open since 2007. So what's interesting is that this QQQX and QYLG aim to essentially do the exact same thing, though I think QQQX has a little bit more flexibility and discretion with how they apply their option strategy. All right, so we've got our four different investments here. We've got the same investing strategy here. We got, for each one of them, we've got three different time periods, because the truth is the oldest fund here is QQQ. It's been open since 1999. Then we've got QQQX, which has been open since 2007. Then we've got QYLD since 2013, and then QYLG since September of 2020. So as a result, we're gonna cover three separate time periods. We're gonna cover first all four investments from the period October 2020 through July of 2021. I know it's not a big time period, but it's all I can work with QYLG. So I'm gonna use that time period, and then we're gonna drop off QYLG and look at the other three funds. The second time period is gonna be from January of 2014 through July of 2021. And that's gonna cover QQQ, QYLD, and QQQX. Then our third time period we're gonna cover is February of 2007 through July of 2021, at which point we will cover only QQQ and QQQX. I don't think I've ever said the letter Q or said Q as many times as I'm gonna say it in this video. I apologize if it sounds weird. It's starting to sound weird. The word Q or the letter Q in my head sounds really weird now. Anyway, let's go ahead and take a look here at the first time period. Oh, by the way, we've got lump sum investment strategy right here. We've got our monthly contribution here and our annual cost of living adjustment related to the monthly contribution here, meaning that every year we increase our monthly contribution by the annual cost of living adjustment, 2% here, which we can adjust. By the way, this spreadsheet, like all the other spreadsheets I have, are available to the Patreon community. So if you're interested in getting more dividend content, getting all access to my spreadsheets, seeing what I do in my own dividend portfolio, keeping up to date with the exact changes I make to my portfolio, as well as other dividend content, then make sure to check out the link in the description below. Okay, so we're gonna look at three different investing strategies here. We're gonna look at, for each time period, not reinvesting dividends, but doing monthly contributions, reinvesting those dividends on a monthly contribution basis, and doing a lump sum investment strategy where we are not reinvesting dividends. Because generally when we talk about lump sum investment, we're thinking about transitioning to living off of these assets rather than actually investing more money. Let's take a look at this first time period here. Okay, so again, this is a very short time period, so the total dividends are very low here. You can see that as we expect, QYLD pays a lot more in dividends than QQQ, and the other two are kind of in between though. QQQX does pay more in dividends, at least recently, than QYLG. And in that short time period, investing $250 a month, they're all still very close together here on that investment. And by the way, with this short time period, the top investment is QQQ. If we look over here with reinvesting those dividends along the way in that short time frame, it's still QQQ, but really close behind it actually is QQQX. And these other two are right in between. We've got QYLG at 2719 and QYLD at 2609. If we look at lump sum investments here, we would see that over that time frame, if we started with the lump sum investment of $250,000, from October through July, we would have, instead of 250, we'd have 272 with QYLD. We would have 304 with QYLG, 324 with QQQX and 335 with QQQ. This is a very short time frame, guys. It's very difficult to see the differences, although at the end of the video, I'm gonna show you some of the graphs that correspond with this data, because sometimes it's helpful to see the graphs to actually understand what's really going on. Coming over here to this time frame now, we're getting rid of QYLG and we're looking at QQQ, QYLD, and QQQX. So now we're looking at not reinvesting dividends. So now we're looking at trailing 12 months of dividends and portfolio value from January of 2014 versus July of 2021. We're keeping our numbers constant here. $250 a month in contributions if we're doing the monthly contributions, and a lump sum investment strategy of $250,000. All right, so under this time frame here, we can see that after about 6.5, almost 7 years, we've got QQQ worth $60,000. We have QYLD worth 23 and QQQX worth 33. This is not reinvesting dividends. As expected, QQQ pays almost nothing in dividends. We've got in between here QQQX at 1790 and then QYLD at 2536. If we look at reinvesting the dividends, we can see that QQQ is worth 62. Then we've got QQQX worth 42 and then 32557 for QYLD. Again, with QYLD paying the most in dividends, QQQX in the middle at 2233 and QQQ only at 226.98. If we do a lump sum investment here, this is very interesting. QQQ is worth 1.04 million, whereas QQQX is worth 421, and we actually had a drop in value for QYLD from 250 to 224. Now, I don't think it's very fair to say, or maybe reasonable is more the appropriate word here, to say that QQQ is going to have a year or a decade like it had this most recent decade. It was just on fire for the past 10 years. And that's why you see it jump from 250 to 1.04 million in just 7 years. It just was off the hook. And I don't think it's reasonable to expect that to happen. I do expect QQQX to be kind of right in the middle with respect to the value, as opposed to being only worth 421 here, whereas you might expect it to be worth maybe more like $500,000 or $600,000. Though I would say that how QQQX performs is gonna be very dependent on options premiums with respect to the NASDAQ 100. As long as options premiums stay elevated, QQQX will perform well. If it drops in value, then you'll see a significant difference between the QQQ NASDAQ 100 and the actual 50-50 split on options writing and the NASDAQ 100. And then last time period here, we've got February of 2007 to July of 2021, so about 14 years or so. And it's going, we're just working with two different investments here, QQQ and QQQX. I forgot, that's so many Qs. If we're looking at not reinvesting dividends, we've got the NASDAQ 100, QQQ worth 219,826, and we've got QQQX, let me just scroll over further so we can see it here, worth 77,788, and then a significant amount of dividends for QQQX versus QQQ. And then if we're looking at reinvesting those dividends, we see a much bigger jump here for QQQX. We'd have 239 instead of 219 for QQQ, and 150 or 149 versus 77 with QQQX. Still not, you know, anywhere near the amount of portfolio value. But again, QQQ had an amazing period from about 2009 through 2021. And again, we see a significant increase in dividends paid here, 8133 for QQQX versus 890 with QQQ. And then if we look at just a lump sum investment strategy here, where we're not reinvesting dividends, we're just lump sum investing here, we'd have $2.08 million for QQQ versus 365 for QQQX. And then 7806 in trailing 12 months of dividends versus just a hair under 21,000 for QQQX. Let's take a look at some of the graphs here to see how some of the data changes. This is just the first time period, that October through July. This is not reinvesting dividends and reinvesting dividends here. Not a lot of time to look at the differences in total value. It's very close together under that short time frame. Let's go down and look a little bit farther here. This is the lump sum investment strategy. What would happen to these investments over that October 2020 to July 2021 timeframe, starting at 250, you can see here that the numbers for QQQX versus QQQ are very similar here. In fact, at one point, QQQ was worth less than QQQX. And then as we would expect, we've got QYLG here, kind of in between in the pack here, and QYLD down below. All right, this is the second time frame here. We're looking at total value from January of 2014 through to July of 2021. Let me start with just showing you the non-reinvested dividends here, just to make sure that the graph is not too busy for us. All right, so we got three different investments here. We've got QQQ up here for that 7 year time frame. Then we've got QQQX right here, and we've got QYLD. As we would expect, QQQX performs kind of in the middle, though definitely on the lower side, I would say. compared to QQQ. And what's very interesting here is, you know, for the most part, I would say that it performed exactly how it was supposed to, right in between here, and then things just kind of really took off for QQQ, the NASDAQ 100, starting right after the COVID correction. What is interesting here is if we reinvest dividends, let's go ahead and show that change to here. Instead of showing just these three, we'll show the reinvested dividends. This bottom one here is QYLD, just don't pay attention to that one here, but the other three are the reinvested strategies. So yellow is QYLD reinvested dividends, QQQX is the blue reinvested dividends, and the green is QQQ with reinvested dividends. You can see that pretty much everything stayed about the same for these, especially with QQQX and QQQ, up until right about here, right around 2018. We get a little bit of difference here, and then things really take off. About the same differences and declines for these three investments during the COVID correction, then, you know, QQQ just takes off, while the others are just moderate gains. And then we've got total value with a lump sum investing strategy, which is interesting. We start with 250 here. We can see that during this 7-year time frame, QYLD just stays flat right here. Started at 250, at the end worth 224, lost value. And then we can see here, starting with 250 for QQQX, we end up with, what is it, like 421, excuse me. And then of course, you know, QQQ just takes off here and is just elevated all along the way here and just really took off after COVID. And then lastly here, looking at just QQQ and QQQX, we can see here the total value with lump sum investments from February of 2007 to July of 2021. Things are about the same here, and then really starting in 2017, 2016 or so, things just really take off for QQQ. And then we've got total value with reinvested dividends here for these two investments. You can see that it really brings QQQX and more in line here with when we're reinvesting dividends. It's almost about the same here all the way through 2018, even down here to 2018, 2019, and then we really have some breakaway during COVID where QQQ really increases their value. Very interesting to see these different graphs. Ultimately, at the end of the day, guys, I'm not here to make an investing recommendation for you here, but if you're somebody that loves the idea of cash flow, but you're a little bit concerned about losing any capital appreciation, you could take a little bit out of QYLD and move it into QQQX, which gets you a partial, or QYLG really for that matter, just gets you a little bit of a partial capital appreciation element to it and still have a significant cash flow with right around 6% dividend yield. But if you're really about cash flow and you're not too concerned about the depreciating value of QQQ, I'm losing my mind here, QYLD, at least what's historically happened, then you can just keep it all in QYLD or at least add that to your portfolio and not QQQX or QYLG. Again, if you're a long-term investor and you really wanna have a participation in growth, then owning just the NASDAQ 100, either it's QQQ or a growth index, still might be a great option for you. For the record, just to explain how these investments incorporate into my own strategy, guys, I do own about 2.5% of my dividend portfolio is in QYLD. I also have 2.5% in RYLD, which is the Russell 2000 Covered Call ETF. And I don't own QQQ, but I do own something very similar. I own the Vanguard Growth Index in my 401k. Hopefully you found some value from this video, guys. You learned something new. You found out how we can incorporate maybe a moderate covered call strategy as opposed to going full bore into QYLD or sticking with QQQ with just the NASDAQ 100. Make sure to leave your 2 cents in the comments below. Let me know what you thought of this video, what other topics you want me to talk more about, and everything in between, guys. I want to get your feedback on the videos I make. That's all I got for you guys in this video. Have a great rest of your day, and please continue to stay healthy, both physically and financially. Have a good one.